I was contacted by someone who I consider to be a visionary. He saw Ricardo doing this, and he saw me doing that. And he says, the two should do this together. We have something in common. We both love the music of Frank Zappa. At this point in my life, I am only performing with musicians who have performed at the highest standard of musicality. With Frank Zappa, I played with the best that existed. When Federico gave me information about Ricardo, I listened to it, and I, in my opinion, they are in the same class of musician, some of the best. Italy, Rome, I was doing tours with the grandmothers. The grandmothers of invention, you know. Don Preston on keyboards, Tom Fowler on bass. Of course, myself as a singer, saxophone player, flauté. And a local drummer from Los Angeles, and many different guitar players, but very good guitar players. I think the Italian audience are very intelligent because they know good music. They don't just like Frank Zappa because he's Italian and a little bit Sicilian. See, the culture of the Italian people is very similar to the culture of the people in Brazil. Music in Brazil with the music with the people and music in Italy, they are a marriage. Music and the Italian people, music and the Brazilian people. Basically, he discovered me in Hawaii because I was everything you have seen me do with Frank Zappa, I was already doing in Hawaii with my own band. The name of the band was Communication Plus. We communicate with you plus. We live the music, we don't just play the music. Santana came to town, he wanted to sit in with us because someone told him, hey, these people were playing Evil Ways before you recorded it. How is this possible? Did you get the song from them? There's only two kinds of music, you know. It's good and it's bad. Doesn't care what kind. Jazz, rock and roll, rhythm and blues, classical, country, blues. There's only two kinds. It's good or it's bad. If you listen to the CD I released of the night that Frank Zappa and I met in Hawaii. And the name of the CD is, This Is What Frank Zappa Heard. Because every since I was with Frank Zappa, every time I have an interview, or every time I talk with someone, a journalist, their question is, what were you doing when Frank Zappa saw you? Where did he find you and what were you doing that impressed him to say to you, at the very moment, my name is Frank Zappa, and you are my new lead vocalist frontman. Well, I just might grow me some bees, but I'd leave the sweet stuff to somebody else. How about you there? But then on the other hand, everyone wants to know, what was it to inspire this genius to walk up to you and say this? So I released the CD because I was recording that night. So now when they ask the question, I say, here, listen to this. Now one thing on the CD that's really, really important to give you an insight into how Frank Zappa was impressed, okay? At the end of one song on the CD, if you listen carefully, you hear one of the people in the club come up to me at the stage and it says, Napoleon, you son of a bitch, I hate you. I said, okay. He says, every time you play music, I can't listen to the original at home anymore because you always play it better. I can't listen to the original, I have to come and listen to you, and I hate you. This was the effect my band and the performance that we gave every night, because we lived the music every night for 6 hours. This is that on Frank Zappa. The thing about Frank Zappa music is that it attracts the intelligent listener. If you are in love with rap, you want to like Zappa.
Questo progetto nasce come sviluppo di un'idea che originariamente fu fatta anni fa, sempre con la Thank You Band, con il famoso disco di Frank Zappa, appunto, che si fece la Thank You Band, no? E a questo punto sto lavorando su dei pezzi nuovi da arrangiare, sono delle cose pensate anche insieme a Napoleon, quindi dei brani scelti del periodo anni 70, che sono quelli anche appartenenti al disco Roxy Elsewhere o One Size Fits All, quel periodo lì, insomma, ecco. Quindi un progetto molto dedicato proprio a una fase delle più interessanti della musica di Frank Zappa. Quasi una big band, ci sono due trombe, trombone, basso tuba, tre sassofoni, tastiere, chitarra, vibrafono, basso, batteria. Quindi è un organico che può assomigliare a quello del disco Grand Wazoo di Frank Zappa, c'è una formazione comunque allargata dove c'è questo suono grande e quindi gli strumenti valorizzano ancora di più la musica di Frank Zappa. La novità è l'approccio di ora, che non è l'approccio di qualche anno fa, e diciamo la presenza di Napoleon, che è la presenza di un cantante, e poi anche la scelta dei brani, che sono brani di tipo diverso, quindi abbiamo diverse cose, insomma, ecco, diversi elementi che fanno l'effetto differente, ma comunque essendo musica jazz e quindi sempre molto mutevole, quando si fa una cosa qualche anno dopo non c'è problema, sarà sempre diversa, non si ripete mai. E quindi vi aspettiamo al nostro concerto il 6 novembre al Crossroad di Roma con Napoleon Murphy Brock e la Thank You Band.
And we will be doing music from Roxy and Elsewhere and Roxy the movie. After 40 years of delay, finally, it's going to be released. And if you love Roxy and Elsewhere all your Zappa life, now you will be able to understand visually why you like it so much.